Greetings, all praising His Imperial Majesty, the Conquering Lion. Hail Selassie I, I of Ethiopia. Welcome to Eyewitness, where Ras reasons to discuss issues pertaining to I faith. Today, the Christ having come 2 millenniums ago to declare the gospel, the work, good tidings for all. And I seek truth always from the beginning to the end. The truth stands as I law proclaimed in I scripture, of I faith upheld by I majesty, I Lord, I Savior, His Imperial Majesty King Selassie I Rastafari. And this existence is Him's story. That being which consists of truth completely, with no fallacy. I seek our light, and I reveal on Judgment Day. My people are at war with thy enemy, the great opponent, Satan, who seeks to rule over the flesh. Satan's way is man's way, and Lord's way is I way. Satan seeks to make his way I way, and it could not happen because it has been written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord your God. This being from Deuteronomy. And so, how is it that Satan seeks to rule? Through warfare. Satan's war against thy spirit. Satan, having existed as a spirit to come and rule the flesh, this being known as sin, and having power over the body. And so I seek to free thyself, to clean thy temple, to make way for Lord to enter and to bring thy fruit of thy season. And in this, I and I our testimony, to proclaim the good works. And that is thy truth. Man seeks to prove this wrong, so the man disguises and makes an attempt to collect that which be detrimental to your cause. The man is a professional. The man works as a unit. The man is not alone in his operation. He believes in what he does. And he believes a man measures himself against himself, and yet I only Lord is judge supreme, and Lord will tell I what I need to know. So long as I choose to follow I command given forth by I General. And so how is it that the man seeks to prove I wrong? Well, the man has many methods. His way of making perceptions about individuals is what can be considered as framing. And this also corresponds with define. Because when man makes a definition about a particular subject matter, or even something as simple as a word, man is attempting to frame, which is painting a portrait or some kind of impression, as an impression leaves a mark. That mark, and therefore the man inherits power by increasing the base of servitude. And this base forming a component of the construct, as I state, man seeks to prove you wrong, and yet the man is in disguise. And so the man seeks for others to do his work. So he will set a construct so that particular individuals will be watched and as a result framed, so he can prove them wrong. Now, what are the motives? I must think as an inspector, and I must determine what the motives are. Well, the man has sought to retain his level of privilege, known as a class or status or title. That's simply power. Man has served and not serving. I seek to serve. even the Christ came to minister, not to be ministered unto. And so, to continue, to exist on this level, at the top, as we know, of Genesis 11 and the Tower of Babel, that man sought to reach the heavens. When you go to the city and you see the skyscraper, you must know that the top is the most important level, that those are the highest price real estates in the world. And man, through the worship of his gods, believes that he is acquired power from these ancient practices of paganism. So, in the process of attempting to prove I truth invalid, man attempts to write history. And this is mostly what we see within that man's channel through his network or structure, combined equates to historical value. Therefore, posterity looks back and determines their decisions based on previous outcomes, and these outcomes being a result of invalid input because of bias. It's subjective matter. That man records what man chooses to record and discards that which he determines to be unworthy. Who is this man at the top of the tower, determined to prove you wrong and define his image to be godly? He works by incentivization. He's providing motives, some kind of a drive, an emotional stigma, something man is energizing people with. This is his way of increasing the servitude base or generating maximum productivity. That is his goal. He's seeking to dismiss philosophy that does not correspond with history. This philosophy being I Foundation, I People from Inception, I Rest Upon. The man that seeks to sow seeds of hate, deception, to trick the minds of the multitude to believing in a lie. So therefore, when the matter is concerning I King, there is much misconception, and it is my duty to set my story straight. How does the man go about achieving his mischief? Through provocation. That man is looking to irritate you because he's instigating you. And as an interrogation, the objective is to rouse the emotions of the subject in suspicion, because as the man knows, he will obtain more information. It's like giving a person a drink of whiskey. You know, in the movies when somebody's given, you sit down, they're sweating, you give them whiskey. The man again will now take the information and he will use what he can to his advantage and dismiss all the rest. How are the man carrying out these tactics? Well, these are ancient practices. Division amongst people on the bottom has been done for many cultures. These practices have developed as this dominant culture known as the Babylonian culture evolves, so do the practices. They have become more sophisticated. They can be known as witchcraft collectively. For the purposes of study, there's no difference between witchcraft and sorcery and wizardry. But these are methods that are being used that appear one way on the surface and are actually not. So, deception. The art of deception. Today, the word propaganda is often used, and it is a component of this art. On this place, within the comments, many times people are disguised. Sometimes those comments are generated by machines, many, many of them. These are cloaks to hide those that may be, you know, speaking truth. And so, like, a word may be tossed around that sounds like repulsive, like troll, and it is to give that impression on someone that if you see this kind of material, this is why. To define what it is people are seeing. And therefore, you know, that first impression is the most strongest, lasting. So the man seeks to make this impression first. If the man has watched, for example, some of these videos, he will determine which one is the most uninteresting, let's say, or even just in air. He will project that video if he determines the subject to be one of threatening nature. The man is coming in all kinds of disguise. There was another one of these stars. That star, five-pointed, is. It stands for the goddess of victory, Columbia, which this United States is founded on. So that is the man's faith, paganism, worship of gods, and not worship of I Wei, one Father, Almighty, Most High. And that being distinguishing I people from the heathen. Today, the man has claimed stake on I Faith to say that he represents I people. This is the sheep being led by the wolf. I people are warned to not make unrighteous judgment by appearance, but to judge I heart. And so it is a very careful matter, and yet many of these congregations have taken this role because they are not adequately addressing the issues of the day. And one could say that perhaps have not for quite some time because of this construct of framework, which is an institutional model based on man's code, not Lord. Man sought to make his code as the supreme law. And so through these branches, man is rejecting his image of falsehood and turning the eyes of those that can see away from thy truth. Blind minds of the multitude into worshiping and serving the beast. And now, man has destroyed the planet Earth. Now, the man is seeking to blame something other than himself. Yes, so seeks to prove you wrong. He's going to try to find something. Because if he says he can find something, then he can take everything you've done.